determining how many times one amount fits into another, or how many times bigger one amount is than another, may involve whole numbers or fractions. For both types of numbers, the basic idea of division is the same. In 40 years of teaching math courses for future teachers, there were always students who were surprised to find that division of fractions had the same meaning as division of whole numbers. In this video, division of fractions will be connected to division of whole numbers in two ways. If a cook has 2/3 of a cup of cocoa, represented by the shaded amount of the top bar, and a batch of chocolate cookies requires 1/6 cup of cocoa, represented by the lower bar, how many batches of cookies can be made? Now we can see that the shaded amount of the top bar is 4 times greater than the shaded amount of the lower bar, or that the shaded amount of the lower bar fits into the shaded amount of the top bar 1, 2, 3, 4 times. The idea of goes into is one way division of whole numbers is taught. For example, how many times does 3 go into or divide into 15? We write 15 divided by 3 equal 5. Similarly, we can use the operation of division in this example, 2/3 divided by 1/6 equals 4. In both of these examples, we can ask how many times does one amount fit into another, and in both with whole numbers and fractions, we can answer the question by division. This is one connection from whole numbers to fractions. The concept of division stays the same. Let's consider another example. If 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda is available, it's represented by the top bar, and 1/12 teaspoon is needed for each pan of biscuits, represented by the lower bar, how many pans of biscuits can be made? Well, we can see that the shaded amount of the lower bar fits into the shaded amount of the top bar 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times. So we can write 1/2 divided by 1/12 equals 6. So 6 pans of biscuits can be made. Let's look at these special cases involving division of fractions. 1/3 divides into 1 3 times, 1/4 into 1 4 times, 1/5 5 times, and 1/6 into a whole bar 6 times. Now one thing students might notice is that these numbers are reciprocals of each other. So another thing they might notice is that 1 divided by 1/3 could be written as 1 times 3, 1 divided by 1/4 equals 1 times 4, 1 divided by 1/5 equals 1 times 5, and 1 divided by 1/6 equals 1 times 6. So to divide the first number by the second, we can multiply the first number times the reciprocal of the second. First number divided by the second, multiply the first number times the reciprocal of the second. Students can see this relationship visually from these special cases. Students can now use this invert and multiply process on the results with the bars that were showed earlier in this video. We saw that 1/6 fits into 2/3 4 times. Now we can use the invert and multiply rule. 2/3 divided by 1/6 is going to be 2/3 times the reciprocal of 1/6. This is going to be 12 over 3, and this is equal to 4. Notice what happens when we replace the 2/3 bar by the equivalent 4/6 bar. Now we can see that 1/6 fits in here 4 times. In fact, this is just a matter of dividing whole numbers, dividing 4 by 1. So 2/3 divided by 1/6 equals 4/6 divided by 1/6. And now we've got the same size parts. In both cases, this is going to be 4 divided by 1, which is 4. So to divide two fractions, replace them by fractions having the same denominator, and then divide the numerators. Doesn't this sound too good to be true? You can divide fractions by dividing whole numbers, once you get the common denominators. This provides another connection from whole numbers to fractions. Let's look at one more example of dividing fractions by getting common denominators. Here we have 2/3 divided by 1/5 2/3 divided by 1/5. Now we can see that 1/5 divides in once, twice, three times, a little bit more than three times. So we've got 2/3 divided by 1/5. Now we'll get common denominators. The common denominator is 15. So we multiply 3 by 5 to get 15. 5 times 2 is 10. 3 times 5 is 15, and 3 times 1 is 3. Now we have pats of the same size. If these are baths, both baths would have 15 pats. We have 10 pats shaded, 3 pats shaded. So we merely divide 10 by 3. 10 divided by 3 is 3 1/3. So 2/3 divided by 1/5 is 3 1/3. Now let's use the invert the divisor method. We've got 2/3 divided by 1/5. It's going to be 2/3 times 5, 10 over 3, equals 3 1/3. Let's label these methods. Common denominator, and down here we'll call this just invert. The invert method is quicker than first getting common denominators, but there's something nice about the common denominator method. In this case, we have a common denominator of 15. The 10 pats and 3 pats are the same size, so we merely divide by whole numbers. The division concept can be seen. But the invert method does not give a sense that one amount is being divided by another. It is easy to see why students using the invert method do not have a conceptual understanding for division of fractions. In this video, we saw two ways in which division of whole numbers is related to division of fractions. One very important connection is that the concept of division is the same for division of whole numbers as for division of fractions. Regardless of the type of numbers being used, we are determining how many times greater one number is than another. Then we looked at two ways to divide one fraction by another, either invert and multiply, or get common denominators for the two fractions and divide one numerator by the other. According to Eugene Smith, in his History of Mathematics, getting common denominators to divide one fraction by another was a method used to divide fractions many years before invert and multiply became popular. The equations game on fractionbars.com can be played with either fraction bars or fraction playing cards. The object is to drag the bars into the 10 blanks to form all four equations. This game can be a challenge, and moving the bars involves computation and trial and error. However, it will always be possible to form all four equations. The player has formed one equation, the equation involving division. The player has one more equation to form. Okay, the player has formed all four equations and will click Go to check the results. All four equations are correct as shown by the check marks. The player scored 10 points for these four equations. There are three rounds of 10 fractions each, and the player wins the game with a total of at least 21 points.